suppose that's why I was born in it.
If something wonderful were to happen, you'd think it'd enlighten them.
But nothing wonderful ever does happen to us.
Two wonderful things are about to happen. Marmee Warrior coming up the walk.
Won't some of you come for a drive?
Much obliged, but I'm busy.
We agree we'll be ready in a minute.
Oh, there's a telegraph for you, Madame Mother.
Mrs. March, your husband is very ill. Come at once. S. Hill, Link Hospital, Washington.
I shall go at once, but it may be too late. Oh, children, help me to bear it. Now, girls, there's no time to cry. Where's Lori?
Here, ma'am. Oh, please, let me do something.
Send a telegram saying I'll come at once.
Yes, ma'am. I'm going to offer myself as an escort.
Oh, that's too kind.
Honestly, ma'am, it's no trouble at all.
I guess I shall accept then.
I'll pack my way.
$25? How did you get this?
It's mine, honestly. I only sold what's mine.
Oh, your beautiful hair!
Oh, Joe, you're one beauty!
Oh, my dear girl! It doesn't look like my Joe, but I love it for it.
It's not like it affects the fate of the nation. Plus, my hair feels deliciously light and looks quite boyish.
Well, girls, that's been quite enough excitement for one night, so off to bed, all of you.
Sorry, I'd do it again tomorrow if I could. It's just the vain part of me that cries. I just want to go to bed. It's too stormy for me to go out with my cold.
I thought you said it was almost well.
It's well enough to go out with Lori, but not well enough to visit the Hummels.
Why don't you go yourself?
The baby is sick and I don't know how to help it.
Just take some soup for the baby.
Thank you. years ago, when Meg did.
Why? Oh, Joe, the homeless baby is dead. It died in my lap this afternoon.
Oh, how dreadful.
It was dreadfully sad. Mrs. Hummel called the doctor, and he said it was dead and to go home and take Belladonna right away, or I'd have the fever too.
No, you won't. Oh, Beth, I should have gone.
Don't be frightened. The doctor said it begins with a sore throat, headaches, and queer feelings of mine, but I took some Belladonna and it's better.
Oh, sweet Beth, let's get you to bed.
The exact minute.
Then I guess I'll be fine.
What do you want?
Beth is sick with scarlet fever, and Amy hasn't had it yet, so we were wondering if she might stay with you.
Well, I guess that's fine, as long as she can make herself useful. Have you heard from your mother?
She says father's doing much better.
Well, that won't last long. He's never had any stamina.
Knock, knock.
Lori!
You couldn't inherit any of these pieces of jewelry. What would it be?
I like the pearls best, but there are no necklaces, and I'm fond of necklaces.
Probably too early for you to be wearing such things.
She said the first one to get married would get the pearls, and she even said that I might get the little turquoise ring.
I'm sure that if you'd be good and mind your manners, she would give you the ring.
I'll be a lamb if I can get the ring. I do like Aunt March, after all. Oh, Lord, sit down and let me put these things away. I have something very serious to show you. Lord, tell me if this is all legal and right, and if I ought to do it, for life is uncertain, and I don't want any ill feeling over my tomb.
This will and testament, I set my hand and seal on this 20th day of November, Anno Domini 1861, Amy Curtis March, what put this in your head? Did somebody tell you about Beth giving away her things?
What about that?
I'm sorry I spoke, but as I did, I'll tell you. One day, Beth was feeling so sick that she told Joe that she wanted to give her piano to Meg, her cats to you, and her dear old doll to Joe. She never thought of a will, and left locks of hair to the rest of us, and all her love to Grandpa.
Don't people put a sort of postscripts to their wills sometimes?
Yes, they're called codicils.
Then put one in mine. I wish to have all my curls cut off and given to my friends. I forgot it, but I want it done, though it will spoil my looks. Is there really any danger about Beth?
I'm afraid so, but you must not worry, so don't cry, dear.
Why are you so angry, Joe?
I've literally been looking for Meg's missing glove all morning, and I could have been reading or writing, but she's so fussy about how she looks, I mean.
You mean you don't know yet?
Don't know what?
Where Meg's glove is.
Of course not. I told you I've been looking for it all morning.
The answer is simple. John Brooke has it, and has since the New Year's party.
Why didn't he give it back?
Isn't it obvious? They're in love. He keeps it in his pocket and carries it everywhere.
You're serious?
Yes, I am. Where are you going?
I'm going to tell Marmy. She'll think it's perfectly awful. Yes, I knew.
How?
It's rather obvious. I'm surprised you didn't notice.
This is just absolutely mortifying. She's going to get married and move away. My heart will be broken because there will be a giant hole in the family. She should marry Teddy. He's rich and he's way handsomer than that Brooke guy.
But she doesn't love Lori. I'd rather her marry the man she loves.
I wish we had all been born boys. Boys aren't as complicated.
That was an awful thing to do, but I could use a new pair of gloves.